Hi everyone, it's Sam from SiteMate. In this video, we're going to show you how to set up a template. So you can think of templates as any type of form that you would normally fill out on paper. So for example, you know, a site diary, pre-start, a permit, a hold point, an inspection test plan, anything like that. And what Dashpivot allows you to do is set up a digital version, which can then be standardized across your workforce and then easily searched or processed using our analytics tools up here. So today we're going to be setting up a simple site diary template to show you what's possible. When you get started, you probably won't have a lot set up within your organization, so I'm going to be setting one up from scratch. So if I click on add new template, you'll see that we've got two options. You know, we've got a public library of free templates, which, you know, straight out of the box are ready to use. You can click on that option to see, you know, we've got hundreds of templates set up now. Or you can create your own from scratch, which is what we'll be doing today. So if I click create your own template, it'll give me a dialog box and ask me for a few things. So in this case, we're setting up a site diary. We'll give it a template ID, which is usually just a unique like document code or document identifier. So in this case, I'll just go SM dash maybe commercial dash 01, and then we'll just give it a form name. In this case, it's a diary. Usually you'll just set this up as like form, diary, permit, checklist, something like that. Basically the shortened version of the template name. The template tags is how you can later down the track organize your templates. So in this case, it's probably, you know, a diary, it's a commercial template. To give you an idea of what this looks like is, you know, once you've got all of these templates set up, you see that we've got these different colors. This is these different tags that we've got set up. You know, if you've set up your entire information management system in here, this is basically the fast way to refine your results. You know, if you've got stacks of templates in here, I can click on commercial and it just shows me the commercial templates. So it's just the fastest way to find things. And we usually recommend setting these up for your different functions. So, you know, safety, quality, enviro, just like what you see here. So yeah, you'll have those options there. You'll set that up. And then you'll see this option here to select between timeline and workflow. And this is really a decision that you have to make, and you can't change it afterward, where you're deciding how you want to process the information and consume the information that you'll be recording. So if your forms are things like diaries, you know, you probably want to select timeline, you know, things that you fill out on a routine basis, and it'll look like this. So, you know, this is another diary template that I've got here. Everything's stored in chronological order, similar to photos. You know, day by day or week by week, as an example. The alternative is this workflow option, which is usually what we'll set up if a form needs to move between different stages in a process and requires sign-off by multiple people or, you know, at multiple steps. So that's usually really handy for things like permits or, in this case, you know, change events. And you'll see that the information is just displayed slightly different. So we've got multiple columns set up. And, you know, as I, you know, if I opened up one of these and I was to go through and sign it off, it would move it from this first column to this second column. That's basically the only difference. So, you know, you make a decision. In this case, because it's a routine form that we'll be filling out on a daily basis, we probably want to store it as a timeline. So I'll click that option and click next. So this is the template builder inside of Dashpivot. This is where the magic happens. You'll see on the left-hand side, you've got a series of fields which you can choose from. In the template builder, all you're doing is selecting from this list and dragging those into the template. So this is the template, and I'm just dragging some of these fields in. And you'll see that we've got several sort of options set up. You know, we're doing a site diary, so we probably have a single date. You'll notice that you've got a couple of options within each field type. So I'll go single date, we'll go daily summary, and we'll make that a multi-line text box, which just gives you more space, so you can add bullet points and things like that. Category field, we might change that to the type of shift, you know, and we want to set it up as, you know, day shift, or night shift, So we've got some options. You can apply different colors and things like that. Site diary, we'll probably put in a section for photos. So I'll drag in a photos section. Photos of, maybe it's progress photos. Progress photos. So we'll have a section for those. And then in a site diary, we'll probably have a couple of sections for recording things like plant materials and subbies. So we might just type in subcontractor labor, and we'll go subcontractor. We'll go start time, and we'll go finish time. We'll add a few extra columns here so that we can put in total hours and comments if required. And you'll see that within each of these sort of columns, you'll have the option to choose how the data is input. So for time, you know, I would suggest setting it up as a number. And total hours definitely needs to be a number. This column, we'll look at this in another video, but this is how we sort of feed this information from our templates into our analytics section. And that will definitely need to be set up as a number. You might also have another column for photos. So you might have photo reference, and we'll just call that photos. So, you know, if there was something specific that happened on this day that was related to this subby, then what we'll do is we will have a photo section for that. So we'll put all of that in. The only other item that we might set up a list for subcontractor. So if we know who the subbies are on the job, we might set up a list. It might be, you know, ABC contractors, XYZ engineering. You get the idea. So we can add some options here. All this means is that instead of having to type it out every day, you can just choose from a drop-down menu. So it makes it much faster to fill these out. Now, I think that we'll probably keep this format here that we have for this table. We'll set that up a few more times for internal labor. So because we've got this field already set up, what we can do is we can just click this plus button and it will just clone that field for us. So we'll change this one to internal labor. So you've got, you know, your external labor, you've got your internal labor, and we might create another table for plant and equipment. So you've got all of that there, and I'll just change this to equipment, or yeah, plant equipment. So yeah, we would remove these, and we would put in, you know, 10-ton excavator, 20-ton crane, as an example. And you can populate as many of these as you'd like, or you can set it up as a list, which we have covered in another video. So check that out. So once we've got sort of all of these fields set up, what we'd like, we've got a signature field at the bottom. It might be, you know, supervisors sign off. So we'll just put that here at the bottom. Once you're happy with all of your fields, you know, maybe you want to rearrange some of them. Maybe I want to put internal labor first, so I'll just click and drag that up here. Maybe I want to put this daily summary underneath this shift, so I'll just drag that down there. Maybe I want to have a section for delays, so I'll come down to the bottom. Maybe I'll add another text field in here. I'll call it delays. Maybe we have a checkbox. Maybe we say, we called the check delays, and we say, were there any delays on site today? And we'll change that to yes, no, or NA. So we can have that there, and then delay description. Something like this. You know, this is all flexible and customizable, so and you can always come back and change it, so don't worry too much when you're first getting started. It's just to see sort of what works for you. Once you're happy with the way that it's been set up, all you have to do is click save, and you'll see that now if I go back to my template section, we've got a site diary template. If I click on it, no forms have been created yet, so we can go ahead and click the add diary button. And you'll see that we've got all of the fields which we set up just before, and our tables as well. So I'll be able to say, okay, today, you know, we'll go to the 26th. It's a day shift, daily summary. You know, we did clearing and grubbing today. Grubbing. We'll put that in there. We'll add some progress photos. We don't have any just yet. because this team is empty, we're just getting started. But if you're out on site on your mobile device, you could take some photos from directly inside of this form as you're filling it out. You can select a subcontractor, add their start time, their finish time, their hours, and you could add as many subbies as required, or as many line items as required. You could add in your photos, put some comments, etc. You get the idea. You can do that for all of these tables. You know, we've got the checkboxes here. You know, maybe there was a delay, maybe there was a traffic incident on, you know, King Street, as an example, and we can sign it off. So we can, you know, plot our signature onto the document, and when we're done, we'll hit save. So you'll have, you know, a single record here. Obviously, you know, over time, as you start to fill out multiple forms, you'll end up with something that looks more like this. So, you know, this is another site diary. You can see all of our records stored in order like this. You know, if you've got a workflow, it'll be set up slightly differently. But within both, you can set up, you can toggle to a register view. So it just takes all of the information that's stored within your forms and displays it like, you know, you would normally see in something like Excel. And you've got the photos there, you've got, you know, your checkboxes, your category fields, and you can start to filter by these. So maybe I want to look at all of the safety incidents, as an example. I can go apply filter, and then it just shows me, all right, these are all the safety incidents that have been recorded. And then, you know, we can select that and we can export it to Excel or export it to PDF or download the form. We've got all of those options stored in there. One of the more advanced sort of features is, you might have noticed that on each of these form thumbnails, these ones look a little bit different to these ones here. The reason is, what we've done is, inside of the template builder, we've gone to a special settings section. So we've got fields and then we've got settings, and we've gone to change what we display on the thumbnail, and the thumbnail is what you see here. So what I can do is I can decide, okay, I want to display the date of the event. So that's what's going to appear on here, something like this. Or I can choose, you know, a category field or a text field. So I've got some options there. You can read about it. Just click on this article here and, you know, you've got some examples set up. Have a read. But basically, yeah, you can decide what information you want to decide on these. Makes it, I guess, clearer when you're going to process your information what to click on. The other item that we have here is how we sort the forms. So, you know, when you're filling out something like a site diary, some supervisors prefer to do their diary every single day, in which case, you know, sorting them by creation date is fine. Other times you might have a date field inside of your template. So here we've got date of the event. Maybe we want to sort all of our records in chronological order based on this date. So what we can do is we can just click date of the event, which is the name of this date field. So you'll see that there. So you've got some options there. You know, if your supervisor or your engineer or your foreman likes to do all of their diaries on a Friday, you know, instead of all of the diary records showing up on the same date, you know, they'll be spread out across multiple days based on the date that he puts in the diary, not the date that he created it. So that just about summarizes the templates section. Using the template section, you know, it's possible to set up your entire information management system, your IMS, across multiple functions, so across quality, safety, environment, commercial. If you have any questions, the best place to start is always our help articles, which we've got here. If you can't find anything or you can't find what you're looking for, feel free to send us a message using our live chat. We do our best to get back to you as soon as possible. Thanks for watching.